about these games that I haven't warned you about.
Yes.
The ups and the downs. You're up 30 and it's tied within a second. You're down 30, tied within a field, just like that. Know this. This is the best football team in the United States.
So City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're gonna create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here, they got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
There's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes to all the way to, you know, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled. Now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football. You with the shit, you will get killed. Cool nut, Mr. C, get the NRP. Much love from the SFC. Handle bricks in the back of candlestick. House into the peaks. You better grab it. Shield with the candy. 40 and 50 caliber. Five-time champion. Destroy any challenger. Kids like Barry. Score like Jerry. Skill right here. Feel more than Mary. At City College of San Francisco, academics come first. It's student-athlete, not athlete-student.
Well, the process here is very simple. We have a support system that guides a student-athlete from day one on all the way through graduation. We have an academic counselor that's assigned to our athletic department.
We're one of the few junior colleges in the state of California that has an academic advisor who only works with athletes. Her office is in the athletic center across the hall from my office. And she meets only with student athletes, and she understands all the NCAA regulations and transfer rules that a regular counselor on campus is not privy to.
We strive to give our student athletes a second opportunity academically and athletically so they can succeed in life, not just for their college education, but throughout life.
When you come to City College of San Francisco, you know that you're gonna get a chance to play in championship games. You're gonna get a chance to be exposed and promoted to four-year schools like you've never been before.
Everything's set up for success. Anybody that has the will and the work ethic to come in here and get the job done will succeed.
With the academic resources we have, the coaching staff we have, we provide all the support needed to thrive and be able to accept all the new opportunities that are gonna come your way.
City College of San Francisco extended their winning streak to 15 last week with an opening win over Santa Rosa Junior College. Today they traveled up to the state capital to take on the Sac City Panthers. Will they extend that streak to 16? You'll find out next. Happy Friday night, wherever you may be, and welcome to Hughes Stadium on the campus of Sacramento City College for this matchup between the Sacramento City Panthers and City College of San Francisco Rams. I'm Chris Babcock, and thanks for joining us wherever you may be for this matchup. Last week, Sac City lost in a heartbreaker to American River. They were up 13-12, but gave up a 50-yard field goal with 5 seconds left, and they lost 15-13. They had a number of things not go their way and weren't able to get the opening win. For City College, they beat a very scrappy Santa Rosa Junior College Bear Cub team 30-21 to extend their overall winning streak to 15. Recent history against Sac City, City College has a 45-0 win and a 47-0 win, 37-29 in 2018, and then in the Capital City Bowl, the Rams, as they take the field, won 55-21. According to my research, Sacramento City College has not beat City College of San Francisco since 1983. That's a span of 5 decades. Danny Walker's the head coach for the Panthers in his 12th season, and he's been here since 2002, and they look to bounce back after that tough loss. Jimmy Collins, 56-15 career, 6th season as a head coach for the Rams, the defending state and mythical national champion. And last week, typical opener, some things to correct. Matt Jenner came on the bench, was 15 of 18 for 214 yards and 3 touchdowns. At midfield, we have our coin flip. Our referee is Craig Mears. Our linesman is Brad Werner. Side judge is Brad Steinem, and we'll get the call. So Sacramento City won the toss, and they will take the ball. And we'll be back with the kickoff and more pregame right after this. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. City Football on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football, is brought to you by City College of San Francisco. Learn about the 11-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com, City College of San Francisco Football, a tradition of winning. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, be your best active self, whether you're tiny or big, 2 or 102, or a world-class grandparent, you can find care with our expert, compassionate orthopedic doctors. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, 50 years of food and family, a San Francisco original. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 69 years in San Francisco, stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Sunset Garage, your full-service auto repair shop in San Bruno, serving the San Francisco Peninsula. San Francisco Police Department, Golden Peace, Iron in War. And UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters, Fidelity, Education, Benevolence, Protection.
To see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ran glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
City College of San Francisco, three keys to victory, according to head coach Jimmy Collins: offensive execution, D-line domination, and dominate on special teams. They did a lot of good things once again last week on special teams. For Sac City, they need to score. When you play City College of San Francisco, they're going to put up their points. So you've got to come out and score. And in the last two games, head-to-head, the Panthers have yet to score. So it's important for them to put some points on the board. Don't turn it over and convert on third down. Did a nice job last week. Kicking is Joseph Oliveira. He had three touchbacks. And anytime you can do that to set up your defense, you've done well. So the traveling Rams in their white jerseys, Sac City in their burgundy. This is a historic game. This is the first broadcast, road broadcast, City College has had for their great football program. Speaking of touchbacks, it goes into the end zone, and Sacramento City College will start out on offense. Last week, they only had 115 yards of total offense, 97 passing, and only 18 yards rushing. They gave up six sacks, and they had 12 penalties. The quarterback is Ben Pardee. He was 9 of 17 for 86 yards and a touchdown, and he also had a touchdown rushing. They'll go a 3-by-1 set with the wing in motion going across the formation. Is Johnson the tight end? It's a slant route and it's incomplete. Had an open wide receiver just off target. Miles Williams, who had a catch for a first down last week, was wide open, but the throw was off mark. For City College of San Francisco, they had some nice performances last week. Jaleel Williams had a pick six and two tackles. Andrew Woolward had six tackles. And J.J. Louie had a sack, and he is playing defensive end tonight. Second and 10 for the Panthers. Motion across the formation, and it's a nine route, and it's complete. And that's a lightning bolt play of nearly 25 yards, give him 24 and a first down. It's just simple pitch and catch. Santa Rosa threw a couple of deep balls last week, and the Panthers come out early and hit on the nine route for that play. Nice catch by Williams. That's his second reception of the season, and it's first and 10 near the midfield mark. Inside run, and that's a tackle for loss. And getting right back into the horse that he rode last week, Woolward out of Clayton Valley High School with a TFL. And it's second and 13. That's frustrating as an offense. You hit the big play, you get near the midfield mark, And then just too much penetration by the white jerseys of that good defensive front of the Rams. Second and 12, playing behind the chains. We'll motion and reset in the slot. And then a motion across the formation by Brennis. And it's a in route. It's complete. He'll have to come off the field. But Johnson with the catch. He had two catches last week. Or actually two rushes. It'll make it a very manageable third and four on that inside route that's completed in traffic. About 94 degrees here at kickoff, culminating the hottest week in the history of California, in my humble opinion. So it's not so comfortable out in the field, but it'll get a much better playing opportunity and atmosphere here as the game goes on. Inside run, thinking it's going to be a going on a fourth down look, inside run. Allen had seven carries for 28 yards. It's fourth and four, and the Panthers are going to run, thinking that they would possibly, if they were going to run that on third down, they might come back and go for it on fourth down. Back to receive is Aaron Espero, and he'll have his heels at the 10-yard line. Bounce inside, just outside the 21. The Rams will take over. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. We want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. Ortho care for life.
So the Rams will take over on their own 21-yard line. Jenner at quarterback. Coach Collins will have him change the play at the line of scrimmage. The Rams took the bus from the city at 2 o'clock, got up here early, trying to get acclimated to this weather as best they could. Short route on the sideline. And starting right where he left off last week, out of Clovis West, Piero had a nice game. Can't have really a better first game as a freshman. Piero, five catches for 95 yards and two touchdowns, and makes the chain moving reception there up front for the Rams. Taylor, Fragakis, Jones, Rogers, and Averbuck. 3-by-1 formation, empty backfield. And then they'll reset with a back and the tailback offset to Jenner. And it's a quarterback keeper. And he picks up 5 yards. Something the Rams did a great job of last week is picking up positive yardage on first down. And sometimes they'll huddle. Sometimes they'll play with a little bit of a tempo. But Jenner coming off the bench, 15 of 18, and also had 10 runs for 31 yards. He relieved Jeremy Stevens, who I believe will get some reps tonight as well. They'll continue with that empty backfield and probably reset, and that's what happens. And that's Sean Allen. They'd like to see him get loose tonight with a run game. And he starts there with a 6-yard gain. It'll move the chains for the Rams. Give him seven. Good luck here. Double team at the point of attack and then get to the second level. And they move the chains. Last week, the Rams had 283 yards rushing, 94 rushing, or passing, 283 passing, 94 rushing on 32 attempts. They'd like to get those averages up a little bit there in the running game. 2-by-2 set, little interchange, late throw to the sideline, good coverage by the Panthers. Jamari Jackson, who had five tackles in a TFL, was right in the passing lane. Good coverage. Got to be real careful with these throws to the sidelines. and also over there in coverage was Marcus Jones Jr. So it'll be 2nd and 10 for the Rams. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be for this California JUCO football matchup. And we have some other games in action tonight. We'll try to keep you updated there. Allen pushes forward, picks up 3. Panthers wanted a fumble. Ball ruled down, and it'll be 3rd down and 7. The Rams were pretty good on 3rd down last week and of converting, and a couple times they got breaks on 3rd and longs that extended a drive, one early in the game that the Rams ended up taking advantage. So when Santa Rosa made mistakes defensively, the Rams took advantage. Empty backfield, but you've got to be aware of Jenner's ability to run the football on a quarterback draw. But he'll sling it. All go. Piero working his magic. Tackled down to the 15-yard line. That's about a 35-yard gain. He's got 2 receptions, and they're both chain moving. Just a vertical route right up the seam, and watch him just go and get this football protected in space, in traffic. And just like that, the Rams are inside the American Asphalt red zone. What a little American Asphalt animation for the folks at home. Day will offset from his tight end position. They're looking to go to him. Jenner makes a great decision. Quarterback coaches would say, hey, that might have been your best throw of the game. Throw it out of bounds. You just got inside the red zone. No reason to take a chance. Probably like to see him throw this into the first row, but it goes incomplete, so it'll be 2nd and 10. Three by one set. This time on top of your screen is Aaron Aspero. Jenner, inside route to Piero.
Jenner's pass is complete, number 85, David Piero.
And that'll be another first down. 3 catches, 3 first downs for the Clovis West freshman. So the Rams on a key, we call key 3 possessions, the first one of the game that you have, the last one of the first half, and the first one of the second half. You score on 2 out of 3 on those and are positive or even on the turnover ratio, normally it's a win. So we'll keep track of that throughout the season. Key 3 possessions. And then we've got a timeout. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. We want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. Ortho care for life.
So the Rams take a timeout, scores around Northern California. Butte leads Diablo Valley 7-0. And then we're here at Hughes Stadium in Sacramento. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be. NorCal Sports TV, the streaming home of City College of San Francisco football this season. 2x2 set for the Rams. Allen offset to Jenner's right. It's first and goal from the 5. Motion across the formation by Aspero. Allen moving his feet and cleaning up that pile is a big offensive tackle, Jordan Taylor. Watch 75 finish this play. Just keep blocking, and keep playing. Playing hard. Allen, I love how I've been running inside. Positive gain. Second and 2 from the 2. They'll stay with that 2x2 set. A lot of options down here for Coach Collins. And just waiting for the lights to take effect here at Hughes Stadium. Bad throw, and that's gonna, could go to the house. Bad throw out to the flat. Kalani Riddick had the interception and a near 40-yard return. It'll come back. You just don't throw that. That's a careless pass. Late over the middle. We're going to take another look at it. A plethora of penalties here on flags. He's staring that right down. He would have been better off throwing that ball into the stands. You got to play situational football down there. And so the interception will still hold by Riddick. So instead of having the football out near the 45-yard line, Sac City will start on their own 13. Nice drive by the Rams, but decision-making is such an important, is the most important part of a quarterback's makeup. And knowing it's only, it's second and short, throw the ball away, live for another down, or use your feet. So the Panthers will come in and play a double tight formation. We like to call this ace. Inside run, and the tackle machine, Woolward, is there. Trey Kane, you can see the safety coming right off the edge, right in the middle of your screen, forcing this run inside, and they're slanting. Nice defensive call right there by the Rams, and it'll be somehow got a yard on that. It'll be second and 9. The Panthers break formation. 2x1 set, tight end in motion across the formation is Johnson. It's going to be a screen out here, and the Rams are all over it. No gain. It'll be 3rd and 9. Watch the white jerseys sense the screen, and they're all running to the football. Doesn't take any ability to run the ball. Good things happen, and it'll be 3rd and a long 8. The Rams were able to get to the quarterback a few times last week for some errant passes. They were able to get an interception for a touchdown, Williams. So see what they can dial up here defensively on 3rd and 8. Back to pass, and the Rams run right by the quarterback. But then they rally up to the football, but it'll be enough for a first down. Great effort by the quarterback. So you have to define your rush lanes. We'll take a look at that one more time. And you got to slow down. Once you get past the quarterback, right there, you're in trouble because there's nobody in front. He does a good job of protecting the football. and getting the first down, possibly missed a block in the back. But the Panthers convert on third and long. Got to be disciplined on the pass rush. Play pass. Nine route. He's got a receiver, and it's incomplete. Catching up to that play was Garnell Wilds, Jr. Just another nine route on the play action pass. If that throw is out in front, might have been a touchdown. Good job by Wilds recovering and getting a hand in the passing lane. It'll be second and 10. So last week against Santa Rosa, the Rams gave up 229 yards, 152 passing, 77 rushing on 33 attempts. That's good run defense. Second and 10, little misdirection and goes the wrong way. And then we've got a flag, face mask. So a good play disintegrates with grabbing the face mask, and that'll be a first down. Here's the call from our referee. So it would have been third and probably 18. They've got this stopped. Great job holding the edge, but then grabbing the face mask. You're going to get called every single time. Renga out of Chandler did a nice job of keeping his outside hand free, standing up the blocker and allowing his teammates to run to the football. Unfortunately for them, somebody got grabby and grabbed the face mask. So first down, 40-yard line for the Panthers. No room to run that time. J.J. Louie with the stop and the TFL. So it'll be second and a long 12 yards for a first down. About 3:06 and counting here from Hughes Stadium in the state capital. Three by one set. Bottom of your screen, the corner's pressing, then he'll back off as the motion comes towards him. Inside route completed, and the Rams rally up for the football. Catching traffic by Elijah Johnson. Woolward with the tackle, make it a manageable third and six, taking what the defense gives you. See if they've got something dialed up. It'll be a 2x2 set for the Panthers. Damian Allen offset to Party's right. Back to pass. He's got time to throw. Escapes one potential sacker and throws deep. He's got a receiver off his hands. The scramble rules almost ends up in a big play, but just out of the hands of the outstretched receiver, Miles Williams. Good vision downfield. And just off the hands of the receiver. So it'll be fourth down. And Alejandro Rojas will come on to punt. Punted the ball 10 times last week. This will be his second punt. Two inside the 20. Sparrow at the 20-yard line. Rams try to block it. Sparrow comes up with a fair catch, and he'll take over on his own 28. City College of San Francisco football. American Asphalt. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. Goldmere Italian Restaurant. Dubliner West Portal. Mitchell's Ice Cream, Sunset Garage, San Francisco Police Department, and UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters. Appreciate our partners of helping you bring in this game live on the road in Sacramento. Jenner little five-yard hitch to the sticky hands, Aaron Espero. It'll pick up 6 yards. He had 7 catches for 52 yards last week. Scoreless here at Hughes Stadium. We've got some great historical facts about this great stadium here for later on in the broadcast. I'll say that now, Luis, and then I'll forget about it, so remind me. Getting old, big fella. Bubble screen. And nice tackle in space. The Rams love to run those screens. And they're expecting to try to miss this first tackler, but Jamari Jackson, who had the interception earlier in the game, comes up in space and makes a nice tackle. But still, very manageable 3rd and 2 for the Rams. Gives them a chance to throw it or pass it here. 2-by-2 set. Allen behind Jenner in the pistol. Panthers look like they're going to double A blitz. Out route, complete, fumble, recovered by Sac City and tackled. Aaron Espero, his catch is for a first down, but then dislodged of the football. Well, carrying that football out like that is breaks all rules as far as ball carriers. So, 2 turnovers early in the game, an interception and then a fumble. Espero's got to protect that football, and he already knows that. Penalty on the block in the back. So, the Panthers, who've got 2 big breaks tonight, and they start this drive on their own 49-yard line with 29 seconds left in the first quarter. Run, and the Rams are all over it. That'll be another TFL. They're going to get into the original line of scrimmage. Watch the white jerseys. When they're in the backfield like this, that's good defense. And he, saying his name so much, J.J. Louie again from his end position, just coming down and sealing the edge. End of the first quarter. We're all tied up at 0 here at Hughes Stadium. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
Yeah, from Los Angeles. Heard that. What made you put Miles Little into the camp?
Well, you know, we were looking for an overnight camp that would really help develop his sort of independence. And this looked like a beautiful setting for the kids and also really foster his independence, meet new people. And I want to say one of the best things about this camp, this particular camp, is the ability to see the games live streamed on YouTube. It allows you to not be at camp, but also still participate in that particular part of camp. And so I thought that was really amazing. The announcers were great. The angles, the instant replay, it really made the kids feel special.
Would you bring Miles Little back up to camp?
For sure, 100%. And we're bringing friends. I think one of the wonderful things that I saw when I came to pick him up is how collegial, supportive the older boys are with the younger boys. And I think that is really heartening for me, because that's how I want my boy to be when he grows up. And so I think that he has some really great examples of really kind people.
2nd and 10. Play action pass. And has an open receiver, Williams, but looks like he might have been hearing footsteps. This is a pretty good throw here. You got to explode and go and catch this football, run right through it. Doesn't, and it's incomplete. It'll be 3rd and 10. Statistics in the first quarter, the Rams had 4 first downs to Sac City's 3. The Rams were 2 of 3 on 3rd down. Sac City was 1 of 3. 95 total yards for the Rams, 47 for Sac City. It's 3rd and 10. Half roll to the right, and then getting home. We've said his name so many times. And then there's another gentleman contributing his contribution, Gabe Enriquez, with the sack. And did see the teammate who got there. Let's show that again. We've got time. We got to give our love to our D-line since that was a key three possession. Inside rush. Nelson Rapati with the start tonight gets the half sack. Bad snap. They had that happen last week for a safety. The Rams should just stay away from this football. And it'll be a very short kick, about a 17-yard punt. Sac City had a self-inflicted wound last week with a snap over the punter's head for a safety. And so that was a near another big mistake for them. We'll get our cameras corrected in the at halftime. It's tough when you've got the lights were hadn't take effect. Now they have. We've got one camera set. We'll get the other one fixed. Bear with us. Don't write our governor. He won't listen anyway. I digress. Taylor, the tackle, making sure we have enough guys on the line of scrimmage. Wouldn't be surprised if Sparrow to get a touch here after the fumble. Allen picks up a yard, and it'll be second and 9.
1 yard pickup on the play. Ball for 32-yard line, second down and 9.
It's been a game of turnovers. The Rams moved the football and then had an interception in the end zone, and then a throw would have made it a third and short, maybe even a first down. And a Sparrow, self-inflicted wound, and fumbles. And then the Panthers' offense, though, hasn't been able to take advantage. So they've gone now against City College of San Francisco 9 straight quarters without scoring a touchdown against them. Screen, and I was going nowhere. Chris Lands, he was watching a lot of film this week. How do I know? Because he's reading his key here. Step up, goes back. It's an in window. Just wasn't well timed, and the spacing was not good. You're going to run that screen. You need room to run. And it'll be 3rd and 9, and see if the Panthers dial up here something defensively, or do they just drop back into blanket coverage? Empty backfield. And throw to the sidelines. It's complete, and the catch.
Pulled down by number 84, Azari Brown.
Azari Brown, the freshman, with the chain moving reception. Good timing by Jenner. The throw, the completion, and the first down. First down at the 45-yard line. All tied up at 0 here at historical Hughes Stadium on the campus of Sacramento City College. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be on the World Wide Web. Inside run, and it's stripped, and it's another turnover, and Sac City recovers. 3rd turnover of the night in less than a quarter and a half. Watch the chicken strip here of Allen. Got to see who the number is. It was one of the linebackers, but he got his hand. So it looks like Carlos Lopez got his hand right on the football, stripped it of Allen. So we're scoreless, and the Rams have turned the ball over 3 times. They're going to run a trick play. He's got a receiver, and he's caught. The 10. Touchdown, Sac City. It's not Halloween, but the Panthers run a little trickeration and hit it home. Jamil. Francois with the halfback option pass. And they timed that out perfectly. And that's a 50-yard plus catch and run for a touchdown. And the Panthers take advantage of this turnover. And they go up 7-0. Let's watch that one more time. And we're going to cue the circus music. Well thrown out in front of the receiver, catches and finishes. Miles Williams with the catch. And Sac City takes advantage of the turnover. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. So one turnover, didn't give up a touchdown. Two turnovers, didn't give up a touchdown. Third turnover, the Panthers. They probably have had that play and were waiting to run it at the perfect time, and they did just that. So the Rams have to regroup. That's the first touchdown, the first score that Sac City has scored against City College of San Francisco in 9-plus quarters. And remember, City College of San Francisco has not lost to Sac City since 1983, and so far they're trying to pull up the upset. Short kick. Washington. He had a good game last week. He had some solid yards returning, had 53 yards rushing, a 37-yard kickoff return, and might be time to insert him into the lineup a little bit. But tip of the hat to Coach Walker and his staff for having that trick play and catching and the sudden change taking advantage. So 12-24 in the second quarter, the Panthers hit pay dirt with the halfback pass. Washington, as I suspected, gets into the lineup and he pushes for a 3-yard gain. And quarterback in, change of quarterback, Jeremy Stevens. Was 9 of 12 for 69 yards and a touchdown, but had a pick six. And after that, he was taken out of the game, and Jenner came in for him. So see if the young man can learn from his experience. That's what this thing's all about. Throw high over the middle, and it's incomplete. It'll be third down. Had an open receiver, but just off target. Piero has had three catches already tonight. So Francois to Williams. And it's 7-0 Sac City. Rams, good field position. Third down, where they're 3 of 4 so far tonight. Deep ball. It's going to be a pass interference and a first down. The Sparrow was held, and this will be a first down as the Rams take a shot on third down. Watch last week's broadcast, and I said take a shot. Coach Collins is going to take a shot way too much. I was wrong a lot. They do like to take their shots, but you know, we'll let the game culminate and play out versus trying to play play caller. So here's the call.
Fire the pass. Holding. Defense. 10 yards. Touchdown.
See if the Rams take advantage. Press coverage at the top of the screen. And it goes incomplete. We got a hold. And the Rams, they're on the Panthers' 44-yard line. Little power play. And Washington
the ball carrier,
picks up four
down the 42-yard line.
On the first down run. Rodgers with the pull, but he misses the block. He seals that right there. Washington might carry that for a first down. Positive gain. Sloppy game. I mean, execution-wise, the Rams have moved the football, but just three turnovers is unheard of for them. And a sack. Sack City gets home. Mason Alemeyer with the pass rush. Gets the inside rush, beats Taylor, and the sack. And it'll be third and long. And a lot of times after a sack or a negative play, the Rams will come back with the screen. But I don't know if they could do that here with being third and long, probably about third and 16, third and 15. Stevens, open, complete. Sparrow protecting the football there, and he'll move the chains. Simple pitch and catch here.
Ball 32-yard line, first and 10 Rams.
Nice throw, and Sparrow protecting the football in traffic, and the Rams are at the 32-yard line, first and 10. Day, the tight end. Washington, as the Panthers run to the football. Elijah King, watch number 10 in the burgundy jersey come up and wrap here and finish this play. Right there. And also had some help from his teammate, Ncoma Riddick. So it'll be second and 10 for City College of San Francisco. Stevens at quarterback. Jenner started tonight. Stevens in now. And Stevens will run. And here's his ability. He gets the first. I think this is coming back. It is. I believe this one's on 75. When you're in traffic and blocking like that, you can get away with it. But then once things get exposed, which we need to get more exposure on our lens, which we will, that's the play. So now the Rams are going to be playing behind the chains. Second and 20. Nichols and Pirro at the top of your screen. Washington offset to Stevens left. It's a screen to Pirro. And a nice game. So it'll be cut, split the distance in half. It'll be third and 10. This is a little in-window screen. And you'd like to have him catching that football running, not pausing. So if you can put that a little bit more out in front, he might be able to get a few more yards. But it's third and 10. Third and 10 here for the Rams. Could be four down territory. Stevens out route. Pirro I think he's going to be short of the first down. It'll be fourth down, and I'm sure the Rams will go for it.
Number 85, David Piero. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
Piero with his fifth catch of the game. It'll be fourth down and one, and see what the Rams run their best running play on fourth down. And then Coach Collins will call a timeout. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. City Football on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football, is brought to you by City College of San Francisco. Learn about the 11-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco Football, a tradition of winning. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, be your best active self, whether you're tiny or big, 2 or 102, or a world-class grandparent, you can find care with our expert, compassionate orthopedic doctors. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, 50 years of food and family, a San Francisco original. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 69 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Sunset Garage, your full-service auto repair shop in San Bruno, serving the San Francisco Peninsula. San Francisco Police Department, Golden Peace, Iron in War. And UA... Fourth down. Bootleg. Day. Touchdown. City College of San Francisco. Ryan Day had three catches last week, all for first downs or touchdowns. I love the bootleg play here on fourth and short, and Day gets into the end zone, and with an extra point, the Rams could tie it up. The kick is up, and it's good. And we're tied at seven. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. Put together a nice drive on a fourth down play, the bootleg, and Day gets into the end zone for his second touchdown of the season, and we're all tied up at seven here, and the Rams have a possession without turning the ball over, and they get into the end zone. The Rams are very good on third down, 5 of 7. Sac City is 1 of 4. Their big play was the trick play. Williams from Francois with 12:24 left in the quarter. But then the Rams answer. Rivera has done such a good job this season of kicking the ball into the end zone. and they'll come out and return this. Tackled inside the 20, even better. On the return was Brendan Jennings. And it'll be first and 10 with 7:07 left in the first quarter. Panthers on offense on their own 18-yard line. Scores from around the state. Butte leads Diablo Valley 14-7. And haven't got a score at American River Laney game in Oakland. Stretch play to the right. And that's the biggest gain rushing for the Panthers on first down. The pickup of Francois had the touchdown pass. And here with the stretch play to the boundary. And the biggest gain of the game rushing. And it's second down and one for the Panthers. So I believe the Panthers broke the huddle with 12, if my Chico State math is correct. No. It wasn't correct. And Craig Mears will pick up the flag. It'll be second and short now. And then we've got a timeout. Coach Walker, you're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. We want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back.
After the timeout, second and short, see if the Panthers run some type of play pass. They don't, and the Rams are all over it. And Gabe Inekes again in the backfield.
Number five, Gabriel Inekes.
You got to block that young man. He's having a field day. That's his second tackle for loss. So it was second and one. Now it's going to be third and three for the Panthers. The Rams ended their last drive with a score. Their previous drives were all ended up in turnovers. Reset of the formation. And here's motion towards the Panthers bench, and it's going to be a quarterback draw. And the Panthers aren't able to convert, and it's going to be fourth down.
1 yard pickup of the play brings up fourth down and two.
Talking about their D-line domination was one of the keys of the game. And J.J. Louie, once again, just blowing up the gaps. Not allowing that offensive line of the Panthers to get to the second level. Panthers got to watch the snap here, and there it goes into the end zone. Self-inflicted wound. And it's going to be a safety. So that's been something that has just haunted this team this year, has been the snaps. It cost them 2 points in safety against American River, and I was just mentioning this. It snapped right over the punter's head, and he runs out of bounds. And what this enables the Rams to do is it'll be a free kick for Sac City. And so the Rams are going to be able to get a return. Now they lead 9-7, a team safety on the snap into the end zone. And that's a big break for the Rams here on the road, especially after they just scored a touchdown. So they've run off 9 straight points, and free kick, Rojas will return. And he made the smart play. Sometime a punter can make a play there and kick the ball, but I think he made the wise decision because it looked like the Rams had pretty good pressure, knowing and watching the scout film all week long, trying to take advantage. Aspero takes it on his own 31-yard line. He's got a return. He's at the 40, and he's tackled right at the 29-yard line. Nice return by Aspero. Nearly a 40-yard return from him, and the Rams will have a quick meeting on the sideline. Come out here and sudden change of tempo. I would expect the Rams to throw the football here. Washington will continue in the backfield. Stevens at quarterback threw the touchdown pass on the naked today, and the Rams will start in Spartan formation. See what I know. They run the football, and Washington gets a short gain. Good job by the Panthers defense tonight, creating 3 turnovers, and watch the push up front. Defensive D lineman Mason Allemeyer getting himself on the other side of the line of scrimmage makes the play. So it'll be 2nd and 10. Continue with the double tights. Washington offs is right behind Stevens. Play action pass. Stevens throws into the end zone, and it's caught. Piero, his 3rd touchdown of the early season. 31 yards. And Stevens buying himself a little time, little time, little time. Piero continue to run and goes up and gets the 50-50 ball, and it's a touchdown. 16 straight points for the Rams. And Oliveira on to kick the extra point. And we've got an injured Panther down on the field.
That sounds good.
So Piero has called for the unsportsmanlike conduct. So that'll be marched off on the kickoff. American Asphalt, taking care of business in California for over 35 years. Got to show a little more discipline and act like you've been there, and the young man has. It's his 3rd touchdown on the scramble play. And the kick is up, and it's good. 16 straight points for the Rams.
The Rams 16, the Panthers 7.
And they'll spot up for kickoff. But we want to talk about Hughes Stadium. It opened in 1928 as Sacramento Stadium, now named Hughes Stadium. They used to have midget car racing here back in the day, and also was a huge place for concert. Pink Floyd, the Doobie Brothers, and then this was the Eagles concert. The Eagles, Linda Ronstadt, and Jackson Browne. It was a benefit concert, and I believe at the time Linda Ronstadt was dating the governor of California, Jerry Brown. And I think this is what it was. They worked did this for free. It was a benefit, and it was one of the things that started breaking up the Eagles. I believe it or not, I watched it on their documentary. So historic Hughes Stadium. I actually remembered, Luis. Usually I'll say, and then I never get to it. But Piero with his third touchdown reception, but gets called for the unsportsmanlike, so it'll be marched back 15 yards. So the Rams will now kick from their own 20-yard line. But Stevens with the touchdown pass, using his feet, buying himself some time, and the Clovis West freshman does the rest. And see if Sac City can take advantage of the penalty and the short field. Kick taken by Kalani Riddick. Look at that push. Riddick with a nice return gets on the City College of San Francisco. Watch him move the pile here. A lot of guys coming in with a shoulder. You got to grab some cloth. And good job by him. Sets up the Panthers offense. And here's that return one more time. Watch him drop the shoulder right there. And the pile moves. Panthers football. Good, really good field position. Play action pass. He's under duress. Scrambles, gets out of bounds, picks up about 3 yards.
Steps out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
I believe they said his last name is Partia, so we'll check that. But he scrambled, got out of bounds, and the clock should be running. Just 3 minutes left here at half. Positive gain for the Panthers. Their lone touchdown was on a trick play after a City College of San Francisco turnover. Throw, deep ball, incomplete.
Ortiz pass is incomplete in number 19, Jonathan Breens.
Breens running the nine route up the sideline. Throw was just a little long. Nice shot by Hero Cam. So it'll be third down. And the Rams have one timeout left. Nothing more they would like to get a stop, get the football, and score. And they get the ball to start the third quarter. Half roll. Louis heating up, and it goes incomplete. No penalty. But J.J. Louis, watch 47. Just keep coming. And throw it away. Clock stops. And the Panthers are on to punt. And it's always a mystery this season about the snaps. Despero is back deep. Playing a game in Sacramento. High school graduate from Intercomb High School in Sacramento. Nice kick. Ball will bounce inside the 10. Will be spotted at the 7-yard line. The Rams will take over. We'll keep it here. Trying to get some scores. Update you. Butte leads Diablo Valley 14-7. Doesn't show a score. American River and Laney. We'll try to make a call or a text at halftime to try to get you updated there. Next week, we'll be up at Oroville at Butte College, where the Rams will travel. Traveling in the heat in Sac City will be at Chabot, and that game will be live right here on NorCal Sports TV. Chabot's one of our NorCal Sports TV partners. Stevens hands off to Allen and doesn't pick up much. Doesn't look like the Rams are going to be too aggressive down here in this not so good field position, but they're not going to huddle. They're going to stay right in the quick sugar huddle. Allen cross the 10, they'll spot it at the 11. It'll be third down and 90 seconds left to play here in the first half. I would imagine if they don't get the first down here that Coach Walker would call a timeout. You got to defend Stevens' feet. He's got ability to move the chains with his feet. It's going to be a 59 sprint. And he gets tackled out of bounds, doesn't have to call a timeout. And see if the Panthers try to put something on with a pass, a punt block, or a return.
First out of bounds, number 20, Brandon Jennings.
Not a bad decision by Stevens of just taking this, you know, trying to get something and getting out of bounds and not risking the throw. Making his first appearance of the game is Carson Wood. Four punts last week, two inside the 20. Would have to be like a world record kick if he gets this one inside the 20. Ball will be spotted at the Ram 44-yard line. With 58 seconds left in the half, Sac City does have two timeouts.
Panthers football first and 10.
Sac City has five first downs, two passing, two rushing, one of six on third down. They have 72 yards of total offense. The Rams, 285 yards of total offense, lead 16-7, but have turned over the ball three times. So that was their first drive that ended up in a punt. As time steps up in the pocket, out route, incomplete. We've got a penalty. Pass interference.
Number 81, Miles Williams, penalty markers down.
Short throw, nevertheless. So it'll be a first down. Big break for the Panthers. That stops the clock. They have two timeouts and 52 seconds left. So they don't have to go all throw here necessarily. Rojas is the kicker. Did not attempt the field goal last week. It was 1-2 on PATs. Panthers had lined up offsides. They're moving. Should be a flag. No call. Throw over the middle, incomplete. Should have been a procedure down here. All these guys resetting. There's a reset. Let's show that again. This is just simple mechanics right here. Got to be set for a count, and trust me, he's not. So ball goes incomplete. It'll be second down. Henry on the. With the pass interference, he's taken out of the game and a new corner is inserted. We've got a little stack receivers at the top of your screen closest to City College of San Francisco bench. The Rams are blitzing. Throw incomplete. Rams
pass is incomplete.
Had
once again for Johnson.
pass rush. Not a bad job by the Panther offensive line. Throw goes incomplete. It'll be third and 10. Elijah Johnson was the intended receiver. Is 4 of 12 throwing so far tonight. 13th attempt is complete. It'll be short of the first down.
Pass is complete to number 19, Jonathan Green.
And I believe Coach Walker calls the timeout, and he does. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. It'll be fourth in a long three. Coach Walker calls a timeout. It looks as if they're going to bring on the kicking team to attempt a 42, 43-yard field goal. And the important thing is the snap, the hold, the kick. And this season, the snaps have been a mystery as long as well on the punts they have been. The Rams will get the football to start the second half. And as I mentioned, they've got 285 yards of total offense. But they've turned the ball over three times, an interception and two fumbles. So Rojas will come on to attempt the 42-yard field goal. The kick is up. And it's good. Rojas with the 42-yard field goal. And it's 16-10. As they take advantage, good return, short field after the take, just taking advantage there. Good job by the Panthers trying to close out the half. After the Panthers got the stop, had a pass interference call, and that really extended the drive. Rojas, his first field goal of the season with 31 seconds left in the half, was a scoreless first quarter. Second quarter, 26 points scored. And Rams do have a timeout. Espero, a capable returner. The Panthers have been directionally kicking, so we'll see what happens here with this particular play. Don't want to be caught off guard. Squib kick. Espero gets good field position for the Rams. Not much time, but set up pretty well. Ball at their own 43-yard line. No penalty thrown. Watch the explosion here and just taking advantage. The quality return for Espero, who had a fumble early in the game. Rams will empty the backfield. 3-by-2 set. They've got one timeout left. They can stop the clock temporarily with a first down. Stevens. Throw along the sideline is incomplete. I believe the receiver was out of bounds initially. Azari Brown right here in front of the Panthers bench. Hard to tell. Ruled incomplete. Officials had a better look at it than I did. It'll be second and 10. 14 seconds left in the half. Steven steps up, short route, tackled inbounds, and I don't think Coach Collins is going to call a timeout. Completion to Brown, and that'll be the last play of the first half. On the shallow cross, Panthers do a good job of rallying up, and that will be the first half. Quick recap. Francois to Williams for a 48-yard touchdown pass after a turnover by the Rams. And Sac City scored their first touchdown against City College of San Francisco in 9-plus quarters. Then Stevens today on a fourth down, brilliant called naked play by Coach Collins to tie it up at 7. Then a bad snap and a team safety for the Rams to make it 9-7. Then Stevens to Piero for his third touchdown of the season to make it 16-7. And then Rojas with the field goal. And it's 16-10, City College. The Rams will get the ball to start the second half. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
Pedics and Spine. Ortho care for life.
You drove all the way up from Los Angeles. Heard that. What made you put Miles Little into the camp?
Well, you know, we were looking for an overnight camp that would really help develop his sort of independence. And this looked like a beautiful setting for the kids, and also really foster his independence, meet new people. And I want to say one of the best things about this camp, this particular camp, is the ability to see the games live streamed on YouTube. It allows you to not be at camp, but also still participate in that particular part of camp. And so I thought that was really amazing. The announcers were great. The angles, the instant replay, it really made the kids feel special.
Would you bring Miles Little back up to camp?
For sure, 100%, and we're bringing friends. I think one of the wonderful things that I saw when I came to pick him up is how collegial, supportive the older boys are with the younger boys. And I think that that is really heartening for me, because that's how I want my boy to be when he grows up. And so I think that he has some really great examples of really kind people on and off the court here.
City Football on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football, is brought to you by City College of San Francisco. Learn about the 11-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco Football, a tradition of winning. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, be your best active self, whether you're tiny or big, 2 or 102, or a world-class grandparent, you can find care with our expert, compassionate orthopedic doctors. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, 50 years of food and family, a San Francisco original. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 69 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Sunset Garage, your full-service auto repair shop in San Bruno, serving the San Francisco Peninsula. San Francisco Police Department, Golden Peace, Iron in War. And UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters, fidelity, education, benevolence, protection.
Down 30 times within a second. Know this. This is the best football team in the United
So City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're gonna create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here, they got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
there's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes to all the way to, you know, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled, and now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football.
Much love from the SFC. Handle bricks in the back of candlestick. Houses with peace. You better grab it. Shield with the cannon. 40 and 50 caliber. 5-time champion. Destroy any challenger. Hit like Barry. Score like Jerry. Skill right here. Feel more than Mary.
At City College of San Francisco, academics come first. It's student-athlete, not athlete-student.
Well, the process here is very simple. We have a support system that guides a student-athlete from day one on all the way through graduation. We have an academic counselor that's assigned to our athletic department.
We're one of the few junior colleges in the state of California that has an academic advisor who only works with athletes. Her office is in the athletic center across the hall from my office, and she meets only with student athletes, and she understands all the NCAA regulations and transfer rules that a regular counselor on campus is not privy to.
We strive to give our student athletes a second opportunity academically and athletically so they can succeed in life, not just for their college education, but throughout life.
When you come to City College of San Francisco, you know that you're gonna get a chance to play in championship games. You're gonna get a chance to be exposed and promoted to four-year schools like you've never been before.
Everything's set up for success. Anybody that has the will and the work ethic to come in here and get the job done will succeed.
With the academic resources we have, the coaching staff we have, we provide all the support needed to thrive and be able to accept all the new opportunities that are gonna come your way.
Effect here at Hughes Stadium. Bad throw, and that's gonna could go to the house. Panthers look like they're gonna double A blitz. Out route, complete, fumble, recovered by Sac City and tackled. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be on the World Wide Web. Inside run, and it's stripped, and it's another turnover. The Rams have turned the ball over three times. They're going to run a trick play. And he's got a receiver, and he's caught. The 10. Touchdown! Fourth down. Bootleg. Day. Touchdown! City call. Panthers got to watch the snap here, and there it goes into the end zone. Self-inflicted wound, and it's going to be a safety. Play action pass. Stevens throws into the end zone, and it's caught. Piero. The kick is up, and it's good. Effect here at Hughes Stadium. Bad throw, And that's going to, could go to the house. Panthers look like they're going to double A blitz. Out route, complete, fumble, recovered by Sac City and tackled. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be on the World Wide Web. Inside run, and it's stripped, and it's another turnover. And the Rams have turned the ball over three times. They're going to run a trick play. And he's got a receiver, and he's caught. The 10. Touchdown. Fourth down. Bootleg. Day. Touchdown. City call. Panthers got to watch the snap here, and there it goes into the end zone. Self-inflicted wound, and it's going to be a safety. Play action pass. Stevens throws into the end zone, and it's caught. Piero. The kick is up, and it's good. Effect here at Hughes Stadium. Bad throw. And that's going to, could go to the house. Panthers look like they're going to double A blitz. Out route, complete, fumble, recovered by Sac City and tackled. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be on the World Wide Web. Inside run, and it's stripped, and it's another turnover. And the Rams have turned the ball over three times. They're going to run a trick play. And he's got a receiver. And he's caught. The 10. Touchdown. Fourth down. Bootleg. Day. Touchdown. City call. Panthers got to watch the snap here. And there it goes into the end zone. Self-inflicted wound. And it's going to be a safety. Play action pass. Stevens throws into the end zone. And it's caught. Piero. The kick is up. And it's good. The Panthers, 16-10, scores from around Northern California. Laney leads American River 6-0. Butte leads Diablo Valley 21-14, and here it's 16-10. So last week, the Bay Six went undefeated. You got College of San Mateo beat Sierra College 45-28. Laney beat Modesto JC on the road 26-25 in a shootout late in the game. DVC won at Fresno City 28-21. And Delta got the win at Contra Costa. And, of course, the Rams win over Santa Rosa JC. So the Rams will get the ball to start the second half. Offensively, the Rams had 287 yards of total offense. 10 first downs, 6 passing, 3 rushing, 1 by a penalty. They were 6 of 8 on third down. For the Panthers, they had 6 first downs, 2 each passing, rushing, and penalty on penalties. They were 1 of 7 on third down. They had 79 yards of total offense. .94 passing. Rushing, they were minus 15. So we'll take a quick break and then come right back. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
At Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, we want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, ortho care for life. At Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, We want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, ortho care for life.
So the Rams will get the football. The story of the game for them has been the first half turnovers. They had three turnovers, one in the end zone. And so I'm sure those things got discussed at halftime. It was 94 degrees at kickoff, and right now it's a very comfortable 81 degrees after probably the hottest week in my lifespan in California. So the Panthers will kick off. Rojas, who had a field goal, he'll kick off. It's a squib kick. Washington will grab it around the 26-yard line and get a head of steam. And not one man's going to bring him down. And he, another nice return. He has really helped this offense set up in good field position. Took it around the 26. Protects the football in a crowd, which I like. A near about a 32-yard gain or a return, and the Rams are in really good field position on the Panthers' 43-yard line. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us wherever you may be on the World Wide Web. NorCal Sports TV, the streaming home of the 11-time national state champion, City College of San Francisco. Jenner back in at quarterback. Allen with the run. Only picks up one. The Rams running game just has pounded the football. They have 102 yards rushing, now 104. Allen with the gain. Jenner in the first half had that interception. He's 7-11 for 90 yards, but that costly interception in the end zone. Costly, cost them points. The Rams' defense was able to step up, and then we've got a lineman going a little early, surely. It's a procedure, and now the Rams will be playing behind the chains. Penalties, that's the fifth penalty of the game for the Rams. 4 for 57. The Panthers, 3 of 48. Time of possession, 6:16 in the first half to 13:53 for Sac City. 3-by-1 set for the Rams in white. Jenner, 9 route, got a man. It's complete. Inside the 10. The 9 route up the sideline to Azari Brown. And nice touch by Jenner. I love the throw. Give a chance for the receiver to make the play. Put some air underneath it. Makes the catch inside the 9-yard line. Marked at the 8. Brown with his third reception of the game and the longest completion for the Rams, and they're inside the red zone. Now, the last time Jenner was down here, he threw a costly interception. See if the young quarterback can learn from his mistake. Espero down to the 1-yard line. Espero in traffic. Little 3-by-1 set. Somebody goes in, somebody goes out, somebody goes vertical. And the throw was behind Espero. If it's out in front of him, he might score there. Second and goal from the 2. Inside run, and it's a loss of a yard. Good push up front. Look at the burgundy jerseys get through the seams here and end up in the backfield.
Visitors, 71, coming off, one play.
So good defense by the Panthers, stopping the potential RPO by Jenner, playing in space, and the Panthers D-line getting pushed up front. Speed option. Jenner keeps it himself, and he gets into the end zone. And then we've got a penalty on the Panthers after the play. I believe Riddick with a little extracurricular activity with the push away from the football right there at the bottom of your screen. Well, Aspero actually throws the punch. So we'll see what the call is here. And it's usually the second guy that gets caught. Mears, Craig Mears, the referee with the call.
We have a touchdown. After the play, it was flashing lights. Both teams. Number two for the offense, or seven for the defense. That is their first of the game.
So it's unsportsmanlike penalty on both players. Speed option, Jenner gets into the end zone, and then Aspero gets up and he throws. You got to be careful. You get ejected, you're out this game and the first half of the next game. But it's a score on the speed option by Jenner and a key three-possession score by the Rams. And the kick is up and it's good. And the Rams come down and take care of business. And they're up 23-10 with 12:19 left in the third. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. So the Rams go down and score on their first possession of the third quarter and get the touchdown on the speed option by Jenner. So it's 23-10. City College of San Francisco, they'll continue on the road trip. Next week they'll be up at Oroville at Butte College at 1 o'clock, and that game will be shown live right here on NorCal Sports TV. How do you find out about these games? Subscribe to our YouTube channel where you're watching this game right now. YouTube.com/NorCalSportsTV. Riddick takes the football at the one-yard line, and he's met. It's a 21-yard return, and the Panthers will come out with their first possession of the second half. Riddick running hard up the middle, but a lot of white jerseys not getting blocked.
Ball the 21-yard line. Houston Tampa Panthers.
So the Panthers, 79 yards of total offense, 94 passing, and rushing negative 15. They start out on offense. Inside run and a short gain by Peter Anderson, who gets the carry, maybe a couple yard gain with the inside run towards the Rams bench. See, when the big fellas up front stand up, the big fellas in the burgundy jerseys, then the white jerseys, linebackers, are able to run through those running gaps and make the play. Looks like we've got a cramp. Nelson Ropati will walk off the field, and they'll get some electrolytes in him. We haven't, credit to the teams, in the, obviously it was 94 degrees at kickoff. Now we're in a comfortable 80 degrees, but we haven't seen many players cramping up, so they've preparing all week long. You just can't hydrate before the game. It's a 2 or 3, 4 day process. So it'll be 2nd and 8 for the Panthers, and look like the Rams are going to tee off with a little pass rush here. Thrown into the window, in and out of the hands, goes incomplete. Get a nice push up front by the Rams. Nathan Cole gets a good push up front. And that was the first down play. That's okay. So it'll be 3rd and 7. The Panthers were 1 of 7 on third down. Here's the 2nd down play. And takes on the double team. Splits the double team and gets into the backfield. 3rd down, and the Rams double A gap blitz, and they get home. And who gets there? Number 44, the tackling machine out of Clayton Valley High School. Andrew Woolward. Watch the linebackers shoot the gaps here on the blitz. And gets right home. We have called his name a lot tonight. As the Panthers are on to punt, Woolward with his first sack. He's got a total of 6 tackles, 3 TFLs. Short kick. The Rams will get out of the way. And basically a 20-yard punt, short field for the Rams. We appreciate our partners who are helping us bring you this broadcast. City College of San Francisco Football. American Asphalt. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant. Dubliner West Portal. Mitchell's Ice Cream. Sunset Garage. San Francisco Police Department. And UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters. Allen loses 2. And in the backfield, Dante Adams and Allemeyer. Allemeyer's had a nice game for the Panthers defensively. And it'll be 2nd and 12. Jenner back to pass, scrambles, and he's sacked. Elijah King gets home.
Back at the 46-yard line.
And Allen got to do a better job of pass protection. Let's show that again. It'll be 3rd down. You've got to go and hit this guy, hit him right in the chest with your helmet. And King gets home, and it's a sack, and it's 3rd and 17 for the Rams. In the game, they are 7-9 at 3rd down, and we've got a penalty, and it's an offensive lineman moving early. So it's now 3rd and 24. Situational football. You've got a multi-score lead. It's 3rd and long. You don't want to force it. If it's not there, it's okay to punt. And it's a bubble screen. A sparrow spin cycle, fumbles, and it's Panther football. Second time tonight, Sparrow has coughed up the football in the Panthers' defense. Right spin cycle there. And I believe the chains aren't moving, so I believe the Rams actually recovered. So be about a 13-yard gain. It'll be 4th and 11, and that'll bring on Carson Wood out of San Ramon Valley High School. And if you're Sac City, better pay attention here. Rams could have something off their in their sleeve, up their sleeve rather, with a fake. Little pooch kick. And that'll be spotted. This won't be a very long kick. The ball will be spotted at the 20. Less than a 20-yard kick, and the Panthers will take over. Next week, we'll be up at Oroville as the Rams travel to the North Valley to take on the Roadrunners. That game will be at 1 o'clock right here on NorCal Sports TV. Follow us on social media at NorCal Sports TV, and we'll show you how to subscribe after this play. Handoff. And a gain of 6. Otha Williams, subscribe to our YouTube channel where you're watching this game. We're not going to send you spam emails. We're not going to call you at home. My wife loved this line last week, so I'm going to repeat it and sell you and extend your car warranty. Subscribe. And then all these subscribers, we go to go and get more advertisers. We're able to show more games, have more cameras. But you still have to listen to me. Or you can just put it on mute. Nevertheless, 2nd down and 4 for the Panthers. Play action pass, slant route, little grabby, no call. Dylan Camp out of Terra Nova got physical at the line of scrimmage, and it goes incomplete. Top of your screen, one-on-one coverage. Intended receiver was Miles Williams, who caught the touchdown on the trick play from Francois after another Rams turnover. So the Rams have turned the ball over 3 times. They nearly turned it over again, but a heads-up play and got the recovery. So it's 3rd down. The Panthers have struggled on 3rd down, and that pass goes incomplete. And I believe the Panthers will send on their punt team. And their snaps have been a mystery. Got to expect that you're going to get that throw. And if you're in coverage, you make the catch, curl up, and move the chains. Partee with a pretty good throw in traffic. See if the Rams put a little pressure here. Good snap this time. Rojas with the kick. And that's off of Sparrow. But then he recovers. And then we've got a penalty on the coaching staff of Sac City. Sparrow would have just, we're probably better off just leaving this ball alone. Hopefully we can see this whole play. Watch a coach hit the official right there and call for the flag. And that's not a warning. That is going to be, they've already been warned. But near disaster once again for the Rams. So a play that could have been right there, you got to just get out of the way because it's an oblong. You just never know how that thing is going to bounce. And then you see the coach bumps the official and gets called. And you put your hands up, but the eye in the sky, it never lies. So the Rams are in great field position on the Panther 48-yard line, which looked to be disastrous on the muff punt. Allen offsets to Jenner's right. Bootleg. Deep ball. Piero is covered. Incomplete. Good coverage. Riddick and Jackson on the coverage. They kept Espero back to block here, sealing the end there. And Jenner, he had a second option going right over the middle who's open. Yep. He's got Brown wide open over the middle. You see two guys deep, come back to that second guy. That's something they'll show him on film. Jenner holds on to it and then throws it out. It's juggled, but they give Espero the reception.
Jenner's pass is complete to Espero.
So it'll be third down. And 5 for the Rams. The Rams are 7 of 10 on third down. 339 yards of total offense. Motion across the formation by Dalen I've got to all practice that. Espero with the catch. It won't be a first down. It'll be short.
39-yard line.
DeCaffrey was the man in motion across the formation. So it'll be fourth down. If you're the Panthers, watch the football, because the Rams could try to snap down here, try to lure them offside on this fourth right here. Watch them snap down and see if the Panthers jump. Well, they didn't even try to deke him. Wood with the kick, and that'll go into the end zone for a touchback, and the Panthers will take over on offense. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. First and 10 at the 20-yard line for the Panthers. Stretch play towards the Rams bench. Pickup of 5. Scores. Laney leads American River 6-0. Here's that last play.
Down to the 24-yard line. 4-yard pickup.
And the fullback has got to block somebody. If you're in there, get after it. Butte continues to lead Diablo Valley 21-14. Diablo Valley got the big win last week on the road against Fresno City College.
Got it.
So it'll be second down and 6 for the Panthers. Looking for their first down of the second half. Play action pass. Deep comeback route is complete. And a first down. Breens pushes upfield at 20, comes back down the stem, thrown well, wide open with the catch. Nice job by the Panthers throwing that ball on time. You sell that by coming hard off the line of scrimmage and pushing hard vertically. Then you come down, break towards the outside if you're an old Oakland Raider fan. That's something that Freddie Biletnikoff used to master, the old comeback route to the sideline or come back inside. And we've got a timeout.
Sacramento. First timeout of the half.
You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
at Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, we want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, ortho care for life.
First and 10 for the Panthers after the timeout. See if Coach Walker's got something up his sleeve. It's going to be a quarterback run. And coming up in space and making the play.
Tim Partee with the quarterback keeper around right end.
Is Tim Christian Jr. And it'll be a gain of 3, second and 7. Rams have won 15 straight games, looking to make it 16 here. Number one ranked team in the state. Partee, throw, complete, first down. Breen's basically same type of route he did on the last play, but this time he's inside on the slot. And it's a little out and up. We used to call that the chair route. Because if he had paint on his feet and the route would look like a chair, thus the chair. Keep things simple. And a nice job by the Panthers offense. They got to get a touchdown on the board here and get a stop. Double tight end formation. Stretch play towards the Panthers bench. Positive gain. Gets out of bounds. Will temporarily stop the clock. Williams with the carry. Little pick and pull. And a good job up front by the Panthers edge blockers. Six-yard gain. It'll be second and 4. Nice cut. Nice cut there. Not much room for Williams to run, but watch. This is what you want out of a running back. To get north or south, in this case south, plant a foot in the ground, see if we can get it a little further back. But did a good job of cutting and getting up the field and moves the chains, and it'll be first and 10. He's got 22 yards. On 5 carries. Rams with a lot of guys at the line of scrimmage. Run to the left. And the Rams defense was all over it.
The Williams ball carrier once again.
Oh, looks like the Rams slanted the defensive line towards their bench, and Woolward just cleaned up the play. Another TFL for him. And that's his third of the game. So it'll be second 11 for the Panthers. Last 40 seconds of the third quarter. Seam route incomplete.
His pass is incomplete, intended for Elijah Johnson.
Johnson running the seam route right up the hash. and goes incomplete. So it'll be third down and 11, which more than likely is four down territory. However, Rojas has kicked a 42-yard field goal. Was the last points that Sac City scored, and that was with 31 seconds left in the first half. Rams, looks like they're just going to bring four and drop into coverage, and that's exactly what happens. Throws high, and it's intercepted, and he just takes a knee. Smart play. Jaleel Williams, that's his second interception of the season. You throw high over the middle, up high, and watch Williams come off coverage and make the play. That's his second pick, and that'll stop that drive that they were able to convert a couple of nice throws along the sideline, but then a throw high, you got to put that on a clothesline and throw it with some velocity. The defensive backfield, especially the back half of with the safeties, they just got too much speed. You can't get away with that. So Allen will carry it for 4 yards, and more than likely that'll be the final play of the third quarter. We'll take a quick look before we take a break. A little power play. The Pullers need to run through the hole and don't stop. End of three here from Hugh Stadium in Sacramento. Yeah, City College of San Francisco Rams 23 and the Panthers 10. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. City Football on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football, is brought to you by City College of San Francisco. Learn about the 11-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco Football, a tradition of winning. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, be your best active self. Whether you're tiny or big, 2 or 102, or a world-class grandparent, you can find care with our expert, compassionate orthopedic doctors. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, 50 years of food and family, a San Francisco original. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 69 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Sunset Garage, your full-service auto repair shop in San Bruno, serving the San Francisco Peninsula. San Francisco Police Department, Golden. Stevens in at quarterback, half roll, and then he'll scramble towards the Panthers bench and then throw it into the ground. Good decision. He had, I believe we've got a legal man downfield, but they don't call it. Look at all the linemen that are downfield here, right there. It's okay if you stay engaged, you can be downfield. So they call grounding on Stevens. So it'll be a loss of down. But now the officials will talk about it. Our referee tonight is Craig Mears. So it'll be
loss of down. Down three.
So it'll be third down. We'll get that corrected on our scoreboard. It'll be third down and 8 for the Rams. They are 7 of 11 on third down. McCaffrey was along the sideline. He tried to do his best ballet work along the sideline, but isn't able to stay in bounds. Good pass rush by the Panthers, but the ball goes incomplete. And Carson Wood will be on to punt. Short kick. And the Rams cause a fumble, but the Panthers jump on it and recover. Heads up play by Logan Cunningham to recover that muff punt. And the ball will be spotted at the 37-yard line. I think he owes him a Slurpee. So it'll be first and 10, 14:35. And looks like we're going to have a new quarterback, Jason Lindell. Lindahl, rather, will come in at quarterback for Coach Walker. Motion across the formation. Inside run. And the Rams are all over it, led by Matthew Eskridge out of Desert Pines. Short gain, give them one. It'll be second and 9. Watch 33 fill the hole and make the play. And then everybody else is running to the football. So subscribe. We're going to ask you one more time. Subscribe to our YouTube channel where you're watching this game. YouTube.com/NorCalSportsTV. Be a subscriber. It's just a click and a click. It's that easy. We're not going to call you. We're not going to try to sell you extend your car warranty, etc. The left-hander is under pressure, and he throws it, and it'll be a loss.
Lindahl's pass is complete to number 19, Jonathan Breans.
Breans with a catch, but it'll be a loss. It'll be third and 11. Breans has had a couple of nice chain-moving receptions for the Panthers tonight. Three catches for 40 yards. Lindahl, the quarterback, 6'2", 215-pound freshman. Rams will rush three, then they'll send a late blitzer, which is always a problem to pick up. Lindahl doesn't pick up the first. He runs out of bounds and picks up three.
He's up fourth down and 8 for the Panthers.
Heads up. Sam Siasi could have maybe taken a shot on Lindahl, but he made a good decision of not, because it could have been a penalty and a first down. So did a good job there. Back deep is Espero. And he'll just let this one go. It'll go inside the 20. Will be spotted at the 19-yard line, where the Rams will come out on offense. They scored on their first drive of the second half. Jenner culminated a nice drive on a speed option for a 3-yard touchdown. And Stevens will stay at quarterback, and Allen will be the running back. Double tight end set. We like to call this Spartan formation. It's two tight ends with two receivers together at the top of your screen. Allen, nice cut, another nice cut, and he'll move the chains. And the best running play for him this season right here. Nice cut here, little pull by Rodgers, gets a block, makes another nice cut, and moves the chains. Next week, Sac City will travel down to Hayward to take on the Chabot Gladiators. That game will be on right here on NorCal Sports TV at 5 o'clock. And the Rams will be up at Oroville to take on, beep, beep, the Roadrunners. Speaking of Roadrunners, that's a face mask. Every penalty flag that could be thrown is. And Allen gets the chiropractic work right here. Let's watch this again. Bad decision by the defender to try to go inside, and Rodgers just lets him roll. Eight stays outside. He might make a play there. But Allen with the neck work. And the Rams will move inside Panther territory. Seven penalties for 64 yards for the Rams. Five penalties and 74 yards for the Panthers. And we would like to thank the athletic administration of Sac City. We've done several games here this season, Washington with the run. We appreciate the accommodations. The most well air-conditioned press box in history. And making sure we're set up, so we appreciate the Sac City administration, Mitch Campbell and Paul Carmazzi. Always been gracious host to NorCal Sports TV. Coach Collins will stay with that Spartan formation, double tight with two receivers at the top of your screen. Bubble screen out here, and Aspero. I don't know if he pitched this. If he did, it's going to be a serious conversation, or if the ball popped up. Yeah, did. He's down there. You don't want to do that. Why? Because you're up two scores. It's the fourth quarter. You kind of have this game in control, and that could be a momentum change right there. Stevens with the carry on third down. Gets to the original line of scrimmage, and it'll be fourth down, and we'll see what Coach Collins calls here. And once again, we've said his name a lot, Mason Allemeyer with another tackle. He's combined on 11 tackles tonight. So, Coach Collins brings on the punt team. And it's a little helter-skelter, and they're going to call the timeout.
Timeout. City College, San Francisco, their first of the half.
Their first timeout of the half. And want to thank our partners, City College of San Francisco Football, American Asphalt, Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, Dubliner West Portal, Mitchell's Ice Cream. I imagine they were pretty busy this week in San Francisco. Sunset Garage, San Francisco Police Department, and UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters. So a historic game here tonight. First Rams road broadcast. And we're excited to be here tonight, and we'll be in Oroville next week. Wood on to punt. This will be his fifth punt of the game for him, trying to pin the Panthers deep, and it'll be downed around the 17-yard line by Elias Williams out of El Cerrito. Now does Sac City speed up the tempo? kick inside the 20 for Wood. Ball spotted at the 19. They speed up the tempo, try to go a little no huddle, maybe throw the ball downfield a little bit. Rams aren't playing with the deep safety. Now Kane shifts back, but they'll run the football, and there's a lot of Rams jerseys waiting, specifically Matthew Eskridge once again. But that's all because the defensive line up front just stacking bodies, and then the linebackers are able to run through untouched. So it'll be second and 12. The Panthers, down by 13, continue to huddle. Lindahl in at quarterback. Believe this is his second series. Empty backfield for the Panthers. Quick throw, and it's short gain, and closing quickly is Dylan Camp. When you throw the ball high, you don't give your receiver much of a chance, and Camp with good coverage. It'll be third and 7, where the Panthers have struggled tonight. They are 1 of 11. And that credit goes to the defensive pressure and coverage of the Rams. Situational football. It all starts on third down. Unblocked. Lindahl does a good job of scrambling. He's going to run, and he'll be short of the first down. He'll be 1 yard short, and I would expect Coach Walker to go for it. But Lindahl had his helmet removed.
Right down the 28-yard line.
But the Panthers are going to punt. Good snap, good kick, a sparrow, fair catch, and the ball will be spotted at the 37-yard line where the Rams will take over on offense. So a final, Laney beats American River 13-9, Butte over Diablo Valley. So Diablo Valley's the first Bay 6 team to lose. They lose 28-14 at home. The Eagles of Laney got a big comeback win against MJC last week. Keeper, and Stevens picks up 13 and a first down.
Stevens, quarterback keeper, he's out to midfield.
You can see his ability to move the chains with his feet, protect that football in space. And we've got an official timeout, and it looks like Stevens was shaken up. So Jenner will come in for him. And looks like he got a jam sandwich on his right hand on the tackle. And he's going to be over at the bench trying to throw. First and 10 for the Rams. Washington picks up 6. It'll be second and 4 for the Rams. Are nearing the 400-yard mark in offense. Good blocking up front by the white jerseys. Washington doesn't do a lot of dancing. He finds a hole and he'll drop a shoulder and pick up six, second and four. And although there's 6 minutes left in the game, coaches like to call this a four-minute offense. Get what you get what you deserve. Don't get greedy and move the chains and keep the clock running. Jenner with the run. It'll be third down and short.
Jenner, quarterback keeper, around left end.
And I believe, is that, I don't know, is that a towel? No, it was a towel. I thought it was a penalty flag, but it was a towel. So not a real pretty game for the Rams. Some things to work on, but, you know, it's you're playing in a tough weather. This is a good Sac City defense, and they've been ball hawking tonight. They've created three turnovers. Washington takes the play fake, fools me and Jenner around the end, and picks up a nice gain. I normally don't bite on the fake, but boy, I bit it here. Nice fake by, watch, I mean, Washington. What's, we're going to watch this one again. Just totally, what a good fake by Washington and Jenner. One of the key things of a quarterback besides decision-making is how you can deceive with the football. And Jenner just fooled me big time. Big chunk for him, 30-plus yard gain for him. And it's first and 10. Pick and pull, Washington. And he picks up enough yards to get inside the 10. He's a load. Out of St. Mary's, just a freshman. And also has a nice ability on the return game. So the Rams looking to put this thing away here with a score. Second and six from the 10. Washington moves the chains, and the ball will be spotted. No, I was incorrect on that. Doesn't quite get the enough yards for the first down. It'll be third down and one. Day will come in at tight end. They'll go double tights here. Berardi and Day and Washington at the running back position. Play clock down to 10. 5. Washington. Nice job by the Panthers defense. They're able to move the chains, but held them from getting into the end zone. I don't know if Sac City was misaligned here,
Washington
forward lean gets the first down. Washington keeps his feet moving, and he hits pay dirt, and it's a touchdown. City College of San Francisco. Watch the surge up front and Washington moving his feet and finding a little crease and getting into the end zone. 1 yard run by Washington. Rivera on for the extra point. The kick is up, and it's good. And the Rams lead 30-10. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV.
At Golden State Orthopedics and Spine,
We want you to get your swing back, get your ride back, get your sprint back. With our top-to-toe orthopedic care throughout the Bay Area, we want you to get your life back. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, ortho care for life.
So the Rams hit pay dirt, Washington with the touchdown, and it's 30-10. Squib kick taken by Kadunda Mura and runs it out to just past the 30-yard line. It'll be spotted at the 31. And Lindahl will return at quarterback. Reminder again, Sac City next week will travel down to the Bay Area to take on the Chabot Gladiators at 5 o'clock. That game will be here on NorCal Sports TV at 5 o'clock. And the Rams travel to Butte College to take on the Beep Beep Roadrunners. Throw out here, skipped, it's incomplete. If the ball's in the air, go and get it. Don't wait for it. I don't know if it would have mattered, though. This throw's a little short. Yeah, I don't think it would have mattered. Second and 10. So the Rams, three turnovers tonight in the first half. Nearly muffed, nearly had another turnover, and then nearly had a muffed punt. So there's some things definitely to clean up, but they also did some good things. Specifically, their run defense was ferocious, and they were great on third down. Throw up the middle, and it goes incomplete.
Ortiz pass over the middle. Incomplete, intended for number 19, Jonathan Breans.
Breans on the skinny post. Nice effort by him, but it goes incomplete. So it'll be third down and 10, where Sac City is 8%, 1 of 12. It's like my old geography grades in college. Yep, my wife was a geography major. I digress. 2x2 set. That's an interception. And Partee came into the game. Oh, it's called incomplete. Good pass rush by the Rams. No reason to jump for that football. Henry had an opportunity to pick that off, but then we've got a flag. And, well, we're going to show that play again, but let's have Craig Mears give us a call first.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, defense number 23, 15 yards from previous spot, first down.
So William Harris Jr. is called for the post-play penalty. And I guarantee you that'll get talked about in films tomorrow. Football is a game of situations, and right there you gotta maintain your cool, maintain your composure. So instead of being fourth and 10, it's first and 10. Partee, good job of escaping, throw incomplete. Good coverage by the Rams. It'll be second and 10.
Ortiz's pass is incomplete.
good coverage by the Rams. And they're close to extending their winning streak to 16, 86 seconds away. And I bet you they'll really enjoy getting off the bus in San Francisco, and it'll be about 59 degrees over in Ocean Avenue. Incomplete. It'll be third down and 10, where they are 2 of 13 on third down. I think that's incorrect, because you don't, when you get a penalty on third down and ends up being a first down, you don't get credit of converting a third down. So I believe they're still, I've only converted one third down, but, you know, I only keep stats for the 49ers. I don't know how to do it here for the JC and keep you yapping. Partee, throw, incomplete. And then a penalty.
Partee's pass to Jennifer Williams is incomplete. Penalty marker down.
So the late flag, little contact, and the back judge thought it was a little too much, and the Rams get generous again and commit the penalty. It'd be a first down, and the ball would be spotted at the 39-yard line.
15 yards from the previous spot. Touchdown.
And the Rams are playing some new players, but it's just like in basketball. When you get your subs in, you just don't want to play a free-for-all. You're getting a chance to play on a quality football team. You got to maintain your discipline and build the trust with the coaching staff. Yeah, I remember I put this guy in, and, boy, he really played well. Or I remember when I put him in and he committed that penalty. That's not building trust. Throw out here goes incomplete. And in coverage is Elijah Lawson at a stellar prep. So it'll be second and 10. So I don't know if Partee was hurt. He was taken out of the game. Lindell came back in, and then Partee is back in now with 69 seconds left in the game here from historical Hughes Stadium. Partee, deep throw, incomplete.
Partee's pass is incomplete. 10 for number 81, Miles Williams.
So it'll be third down. For the Rams, or actually for the Panthers. I'm going to look forward to waking up tomorrow and it being 60 degrees in the morning instead of 75 when you walk out the door. And here in this air-conditioned booth, a very chilly 68 degrees. We're very fortunate up here. Pick and pull play. On third down, gain of 4. They'll keep the offense.
Williams, the ball carrier. Well, left hand brought down at the 35-yard line.
That's a little 59. Zone blocking. So it'll be fourth down and 6. The Panthers are 1-1 on fourth down conversions. And the Rams will get the stop, and they'll go to victory formation. So they'll kneel down for the last play of the game. We'll take a break after that and then come back with final statistics and close things out here from Hughes Stadium. The best formation, if you're ahead, is the victory formation. But this is a quality defense of the Panthers, but they've spent a lot of time on the field. Time of possession, City College of San Francisco, nearly, well, after this play will be over 37 minutes. The Panthers, 21 minutes and 7 seconds. Your defense is on the field for a long, long time. And Jenner will take the knee, and that'll be the last play of the game, and the Rams will win their 16th game in a row as they move to 2-0 as they beat Sac City 30-10. We'll have final statistics and closing out here from Hughes Stadium. You're watching City Football on NorCal Sports TV. City Football on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football, is brought to you by City College of San Francisco. Learn about the 11-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco Football, a tradition of winning. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Golden State Orthopedics and Spine, be your best active self, whether you're tiny or big, 2 or 102, or a world-class grandparent, you can find care with our expert, compassionate orthopedic doctors. Goldmere Italian Restaurant, 50 years of food and family, a San Francisco original. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 69 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Sunset Garage, your full-service auto repair shop in San Bruno, serving the San Francisco Peninsula. San Francisco Police Department, Golden Peace, Iron in War. And UA Local 38 Plumbers and Steam Fitters, fidelity, education, benevolence, protection. So the Rams get the road victory 30-10. We'll look at some statistics. The Rams had 434 yards of total offense, 248 yards passing, 186 yards rushing, 3 turnovers. Individually, Jenner was 12 of 17 for 157 yards and an interception, but he also had 3 carries for 33 yards. Jeremy Stevens was 7 of 10 for 91 yards and 2 touchdowns, 4 rushing attempts for 83 yards. Sean Allen, 13 carries, 41 yards, and receiving David Piero once again. Effect here at Hughes Stadium, 99 yards. There's that interception by Jenner early in the game. Defensively, and there's a fumble by Aspero. Woolard had 10 tackles, 3 TFLs. Nikes had 6 tackles, 2 TFLs. And Jaleel Williams-Evans had his second interception of the season. And nice game defensively by Sac City's Mason Allemeyer. He had 11 tackles. So we'll close things up here from Hughes Stadium, where the City College of San Francisco Rams beat Sac City 30-10 to win this week 2 matchup on NorCal Sports TV, and the Rams' 16th win in a row. Thanks to both coaches who helped us prepare for this game, Dan Walker of Sac City and Jimmy Collins of City College of San Francisco, plus a special tip of the hat to Mia Blank, assistant to the head coach at City College of San Francisco, for helping us secure partners for the season. And thanks to the Sac City Athletic Administration, specifically Mitch Campbell and Paul Carmazzi, for their help and hospitality. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/NorCalSportsTV, for alerts of upcoming games. Our next City football game will be Saturday at 1 p.m. as the Rams travel to Oroville to take on the Butte College Beep Beep Roadrunners. You've been watching NorCal Sports TV. Thanks to our crew, Kenny Robinson, Luke Aldovich, and our director, Luis Rangel. I'm Chris Babcock here in the state capitol. Good night, and thanks for being on the show.